Eric Bakker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back to my channel. Let's do a series I've been asked several times on salicylate sensitivity. So I'll explain a bit about what that is in a minute. So this will be a series encompassing quite a few videos, I believe. I think we've got about up to 20 videos in this series. So the channel's going to change. The channel was called Candida Crusher. Soon it's going to be called something else because we're expanding on a whole range of topics now. So I initially focused on digestive problems primarily with people, but now we're going to look at all kinds of dysfunctions, which I've normally seen in my practice for years anyway. So what is salicylate sensitivity? How would I explain that simply to a patient? Well, we like to eat stuff that grows out of the ground. Plants or plants, however you want to say it, depending on what country you live in. So these plants obviously contain chemicals and minerals and vitamins and water. There's lots of stuff that grows in stuff like this, you know, heaps of stuff. And of course, some plants we can eat to our benefit because, you know, they're a food source. Other plants we look at like that because, you know, they're just something nice to look at. We're not going to eat that fig tree over there. Probably get all my mouth burning with all that white sap that it produces anyway. So many, many different chemicals obviously are formed in plants. Plants need to protect themselves from insects, you know, and pathogens and bacteria and fungi, just like our skin needs to protect us. So what plants do is they'll create chemicals, particularly just under the skin and on the skin, but particularly just under it, to really stop insects from chowing down on them. And one of those hormones, chemicals, which is actually a hormone, is called salicylate. Salicylic acid was first isolated from a willow tree, I think it would have been in the 1800s, and eventually that made its way onto the desk of some pharmacy person, and it became aspirin, the wonder drug, the anti-inflammatory, okay? The first non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, really, likely, was aspirin. I think Bayer, the company, German Bayer, actually brought aspirin out. It would have been back in the 20s or 30s. It was probably before World War II. So aspirin's helped a lot of people. As we'll see in a subsequent video, aspirin has an interesting effect on different parts of the immune system, and particularly it can block certain types of, you know, hormones and things that our body makes, which is going to help to reduce inflammation. But in your case, if you're very sensitive to salicylates, you may notice a strong reaction with aspirin. Some people do, some people don't. So some people have become very, very sensitive even to tiny amounts of salicylates. And as we'll talk about later, you know, all sorts of symptoms can be produced. So basically, salicylate sensitivity is when a person's sensitive to any effects of salicylate in the foods or medications they're taking that can create a wide range of symptoms. Okay, it is seen in the clinic. I wouldn't say it's very common. It's one of the more unusual, more rare kind of allergies that, you know, or intolerances that I've really picked up on. I have seen it regularly in the clinic when I did practice, because of course I've seen many people, so you're bound to come across salicylate sensitivity. So, but don't worry, because there's solutions for it. Now, the difficult thing is there are no testing really for it, so, but I'll show you guys out there how you can test at home and check out to see if it is a salicylate problem or not. So stay tuned and keep watching. Thanks for tuning in.